Are you finding it difficult to manage your WooCommerce and eBay stores separately? Want to sell products in both stores and maintain uniformity? Well, here we are with the WooCommerce eBay connector that lets you connect your WooCommerce and eBay stores. Hey guys, I'm Satyam Desai, and today we'll be going through the WooCommerce eBay connector. The WooCommerce eBay connector is a plugin that will integrate your WooCommerce store with the eBay store. It supports two-way syncing, meaning product syncing can be done from WooCommerce to eBay and vice versa. You can map the eBay and WooCommerce categories and also import eBay orders into the WooCommerce store. In today's video, we'll demonstrate the import and export process and also check the configurations available in the connector. But before that, please don't forget to click on the subscribe button and hit the bell icon to get the latest updates from us. Apart from this, I would like to mention that if you need extensions for increasing the sales of your e-commerce store, then you can visit store.webcool.com and explore a number of products for every technology. We also have the user guide for the same in our blog sections, from where you can check the features and configurations to get to know the functionality of the extensions as well. Now, let's move back to our video. All right, so here we are on the WooCommerce dashboard. So we have already installed the WooCommerce eBay connector. So now let's check its configurations. We'll go to add-ons and then click on WooCommerce eBay connector. So you can configure multiple eBay accounts using this connector. We have already configured a connector here with the name Webcool Store. So now let's click on Manage Account. All right. So now first let's check the eBay settings. All right. So first we have the general settings. So I'll go through it. Here in the product import settings, we have default category. So this is the category which will be assigned by default if a specific category has not been already mapped. So here we have the eBay imported order status, which can be set in the various status. We have the email address for report or update sync. We can configure the email as per requirement. And we have other settings as well, which is the create active listing only. We can set it as yes or no. Then we have a create fixed price listing. So basically this is to select only the fixed price products or the all products. Then we have the product image import. So here we can set it as the in the background or during product import. So this what happens in it is that when the product import will happen, we can either set the product image import as to be imported in the background or while the product import is happening. Next, we have the product import only from the global site. So we can enable or disable if the product import has to happen only from the eBay global site. All right. So next we have the product export settings. We have default product quantity. We can set it. Then we have the pin code of item location, the global shipping and the default condition. We can set the global shipping as yes or no. And then the default condition can be set as new, as open box and other options as well. All right. So the next section is auto mapping. We can enable the auto mapping or disable it. So here we have the two options available for the category of auto mapping. We can enable or disable it. Next, we have the product update settings available as well. So while importing or exporting, we can set the fields to be updated. That is a multiple select option. We can select the attributes that need to be updated, and then we can set when those are to be updated, either during manual update, during auto sync, or during both. So we can save that settings. Next, we have several other settings as well, which is the return settings, the shipping or listing settings, the real-time sync, and the price rules. So we'll click on return settings. All right. So here we can define return policy. We can set the defined return policy as return accepted or no returns accepted. Next, we have the refund option, which is money back or replacement, or money back or exchange. This will be as per the buyer's choice as mentioned here. Next, we can set the return within date. So this can be set as 14 days, 30 days, 60 days. And next we have the pay by, which is by the buyer or the seller. And then we can input other information in this field as well. All right. So now let's click on shipping or listing settings. We have various settings available here as well, which we can set as the listing options. So here we can define the default country code type and then the listing duration. And next we have the dispatch option, the dispatch time, when the product will be dispatched after order, shipping service. And next we can set the international shipping service. We can see various options which are available and we can set the different conditions as well. All right, so next we have the domestic shipping options available as well. We can set the priority as per our requirement and this shipping services as well. There are other conditions we can set as well. And you can see the prompts that are available for them here as well. All right, you can save the account here. Next, let's go to real-time sync. In the real-time sync, we have the general settings, which is the eBay to WooCommerce real-time sync. We can set it as enable or disable. Next, we have the select eBay update events. Here we have certain conditions which we can select as per our requirement available here as well. Next, we have the get email alerts for eBay to WooCommerce update and select eBay email alert events, which can be selected for the conditions as well. And then we have the WooCommerce to eBay real-time sync as well. So we have two syncing options, basically from eBay to WooCommerce or WooCommerce to eBay. It works both ways. All right. So next, let's click on price rules. So here you can define various price rules. So we have already defined one price rule, which is from price from to price 1 to 100. And the operation type would be fixed and the operation that will be done will be increased price. We can add another price rule as well by clicking on add price rule, and we can define the conditions from here as well. And we can then save it. All right. So now let's check the other operations that are available. And then finally, we'll check the import and export process as well. So you can see the manage categories. Here you can see the various categories which have been mapped. So I would like to tell you to use this connector for import and export options. It is recommended that you map categories and then manage them as well. So first we'll go to map categories and then we'll go to map eBay primary categories. You can also map this eBay storefront or custom categories. However, the eBay storefront or custom categories are paid and it is not available right now. So we'll first map the eBay primary categories. So here you can see, you can select the WooCommerce store category and the corresponding eBay leaf node category. You can map the categories as per your requirement. We have already mapped most of the categories available for our store. Delete these categories. All right. So once the mapping of categories is done, we can go to manage products. So here we can get the import option available to import the products from eBay to WooCommerce. All right. So I'll click on import products from eBay. Here we get two options to import all of the products or import the products date wise. You can enter a date range right here. So for this, I will click on import all and then click on import products from eBay. All right. So you can see here you can import the products that are available from for eBay. Here the process has been started and the products are being imported. And you can also stop this process in between if you do not wish to proceed further. So I can see here certain 10 products have been created. So I'll stop the process right here. All right. So you can see the imported products, the 10 products that had been imported have been listed right here. All right. So the import process is done. I'll quickly go to export products. All right. So here you can see certain products that have been exported and we can export them as well. So here I am on the export product section. So we have the bulk action available to export to eBay. All right. So now I'll select a product and export it to eBay. Let's select a product. Here I can select a product and then click on bulk action, export to eBay and then apply. So there we have it. The product has been successfully exported to eBay. So I would also like to tell you that while exporting products to eBay, you may encounter some errors. To resolve those, you can refer to our article that we have written by the name of How to Export Products to eBay Store. So you can go through this whole article to get to know how to resolve those errors. So now let's get back. So here you can see all of the settings that are available. I would also like to tell you that you can add multiple eBay accounts. So you can click on Add New, and here you can fill out the details that are required to add those credentials, such as the store name, the select global site, the eBay user ID, the user token. These all can be generated from eBay. Thank you.
So there we have it, a comprehensive workflow of the module. If you have any more queries or require further assistance, please don't hesitate to reach out to us at support@webcool.com or create a ticket at webcool.uvtest.com. We'll see you in the next video. Till then, stay tuned.